Thank you, Dr. Jaggi, for the introduction. It's a privilege to be on Ortho TV always.
Yeah, we can hear and see you.
Super, thank you. So the healing triad involves growth factors, the matrix, and regenerative cells. So growth factors are bioactive signaling molecules. Regenerative cells are mesenchymal stem cells that can differentiate. So that's either from the adipose tissue or from the bone marrow. And then a matrix is needed, a substrate for cell growth. So essentially, these growth factors are used to reduce inflammation and support healing. The regenerative cells are, just a second, yeah, are used for compromised self-healing capacity. And the matrix is used for smaller lesions or defects. Will you excuse me just for a second? Right, thanks. I was just distracted for a bit. Now, so the ACP and the PRP are biological signaling molecules. They are growth factors. BMAC is a combination of both growth factors and regenerative cells. The fibrin CROT is a bit of all three: growth factors, regenerative cells, and the matrix. And I'm sorry, the fibrin CROT actually won't have these mesenchymal stem cells. Whereas something like an ACI procedure, like an autologous chondrocyte implantation, we will use a bit of everything. So there will be growth factors, there'll be the mesenchymal stem cells, and of course, there'll be a scaffold or a matrix. So platelet-rich plasma is defined as any volume of autologous plasma containing a higher platelet count than peripheral blood. So anything more than 1.5 to 3.5 lakh platelets per ml is platelet-rich. And what is ACP then? Autologous conditioned plasma is just a way of preparing the PRP. So there are many ways of preparing a PRP. ACP is one of them. 15 ml of blood is drawn into a double syringe system from a single spin. So sometimes you can get a PRP that's very rich in platelets if you can use the blood in the centrifuge, not one, but two times, rarely three times. But the ACP is prepared with a single spin in the centrifuge at a fixed 1500 RPM for 5 minutes. Now, the ACP proceed, once this is done, you get that entire double syringe kit out of the system. And the ACP is procured by pulling back on the secondary syringe to remove the yellow leukocyte-poor PRP layer. And what remains behind is the leukocyte-rich red blood cell pack behind. So you get somewhere between 4 and 7 mm always. So that's concentrated red blood cells below, buffy coat sort of in the middle, and platelet-rich plasma at the top. It's a single spin for 5 minutes, no anticoagulant use, one single closed system. So the total prep time is much shorter. It's less than 20 minutes. So there are many ways in which you can classify a platelet-rich plasma. One of the conceptual ways of classifying them is mentioned towards the bottom. That's like the DEPA system. So you need to know what's the dose of platelets injected. So a lot of 5 billion platelets injected goes into an A category. Somewhere between 3 and 5 billion goes into B category. And then the capture efficiency. So if you have a platelet capture system where more than 90% of what you're getting is platelets, so that's a very efficient system. So that's DE, and then the purity of PRP. So what's the ratio of the WBC and the platelets? So more platelets, less WBC, the ratio more than 90%, that's an A class. And whether you need to activate the platelets or they're activated itself. Essentially, more the amount of platelets, more the dose injected, and better the ratio of platelets versus WBCs, the better the system is what is traditionally thought. But what we need to see is the clinical effect. So we already know that there's a lot of literature published that proves that the ACP works. There's also a lot of literature published that talks about the ACP having less leukocytes, not zero, no anticoagulant. no external substance inside, and hence no adverse effects or lesser adverse reactions as well. So we know three things in summary for sure. The PRP is superior to the HA for symptomatic knee pain at 6 and 12 months. And this is a meta-analysis I'm talking about. They found that out of the 12 papers that they were reviewing, 6 actually used ACP. And when they collated those results as well, ACP appears to be definitely better than HA for both pain at 6 and 12 months. Now, leukocyte poor PRP may have a greater effect not only on pain, but this paper by Brian Cole talks on functional outcome scores as well. And then PRP is superior to other interarticular injections for both pain relief and functional improvement, not only at 3 months, not only at 6 months, but going on up to 12 months. Anything more than that is questionable, and which is why we come to this concept where PRP is only temporarily influencing the joint environment, the milieu, without actually affecting any joint structure or the progression of disease itself. So why does the ACP work if it's not the best PRP? When we have whole blood, we get PRP out of it. And essentially, we need to think of this concept where what matters is platelets and leukocytes. That's it. So what the platelets do is they go on to release these alpha granules, and then they have growth factors, the TGF-beta, the PDGF, VEGF, BFGF. And all of these induce anabolic activity in a case of osteoarthritis inside the joint. So there's all plus, plus, plus. And then what's red is the leukocytes. What it does is releases inflammatory cytokines, the metalloproteinase, the interleukin 1 beta. These are all catabolic, inflammatory, negative, negative, negative. So PRP systems, what they do and what individual ACP does is very nicely shown on this slide. So there's blood that's black. PRP1 in this paper was ACP, and PRP2 was PRP. In this case, it was a biomed product that selectively concentrated the platelets. So when you see this anabolic activity, all the growth factors, conventional PRP systems, in fact, even the Angel system by Arthrex. So Arthrex is the company that has this ACP machine. So they also have these other systems where they concentrate platelets at a much higher level. So what we are talking here is that the ACP is actually giving us maybe just 2 to 4 times increase in the growth factors, whereas the other conventional PRP systems are giving us much greater anabolic activity. But we should look at this right side as well, where when you see the catabolic or the inflammatory markers, well, the conventional PRP systems increase those as well, whereas the ACP does not. So the summary is that if you have whole blood and then you take out the white is the ACP, once you prepare the ACP, the WBC count becomes half of what was actually present. And the platelet count increases by roughly 1.5 to 2 times. Whereas if you use any of these other mechanisms to prepare PRP, yes, the platelet count really increases 4 and 6 fold, and in some cases 10 and 15 folds as well, but they're not able to reduce the leukocyte count, and that increases as well. So in effect, an ACP has a much greater, much better ratio of platelets versus the leukocytes. So the concept is that for osteoarthritic knees, the ideal PRP formulation shouldn't be thinking of, oh, I want the greatest amount of platelets. No, it should be more about promoting anabolism over catabolism. The ratio of platelets versus the WBCs is the most important thing. And I think that decides the functional outcomes, which is why, given a choice, having the Angel system and other PRP systems available for an osteoarthritic knee for pain and functional score improvement, an ACP is a decent option. All of this keeping in mind that the PRP is a biologically active milieu, and there are so many things that we don't know.